Shock, Nancy Pelosi officially brain dead, claims Moore and Trump are worse than Franken, details are horrific. Zip up your pants, liberals, your double standard is showing. The media and political establishment are all fine and good leading conservatives to the gallows based on phony evidence or none at all, but the second a Democrat or rhino comes under the crosshairs, and they will dive in front of bullets just to save one of their own. Sunday, during an interview on NBC's Meet the Press, House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi, DCA, defended former President Bill Clinton, Senator Al Franken, DMN, and Representative John Conyers, DME, from accusations of sexual misconduct, while slamming Donald Trump and Roy Moore for their own allegations against them, Breitbart reports. About Clinton, Pelosi said, "I think it is a generational change. Let me say the concern we had then was that they were impeaching the President of the United States, and for something that had nothing to do with the performance of his duties and trying to take him out for that reason." Does being an accused rapist and having blowjobs with a young intern in the Oval Office have anything to do with the performance of his duties? What about using your wife's political power to intimidate them into silence? That's a lot of time and energy that could have been spent governing the nation. By your standard, Pelosi, since sexual misconduct allegations have nothing to do with the duties of the president, why are you blasting Republicans so hard? Then she said of Conyers, "We are strengthened by due process just because someone is accused and is it one accusations or two? He has done a great deal to protect women. Right wing is praising him for his work on that and did great work on that. The fact is as John reviews his case I believe he will do the right thing." But Pelosi and her liberal brood call due process victim blaming when it's Republicans who are accused of sexual misconduct. "I don't believe you can equate Senator Franken with Roy Moore. It is two different things," she said of Franken. She's actually right about that. Franken confessed his guilt and apologized instantly for sexually abusing four women, two during his term as senator. There is even photographic evidence, something no accuser against Moore ever had, but Pelosi's dementia probably caused her to overlook this little detail. Moore has fervently denied the allegations, since the only evidence against them was already debunked by key eyewitnesses for his campaign. The only thing Franken and Moore have in common is that neither have stepped down from their political posts, even though one of them obviously needs to. Then she said about Trump, "So many women have had a bad experience. Now they are saying I have had a bad experience and now a person who possibly engaged in that activity is the President of the United States. I'm speaking out." And she called Moore a child molester. It sounds almost as if Pelosi is suggesting Trump sexual harassed and raped her, too. Just by being elected president. Breitbart reported last year at the height of the allegations coming against Trump, Bradford Cohen, lawyer contestant from the show The Apprentice, called out any chance that he sexually harassed or took advantage of women on his show are completely false. "We were shooting almost every day," he said. "While you are on the show you have very limited contact with Mr. Trump, not with other people. No one is ever alone with Mr. Trump, while the shooting is occurring, in terms of contestants." Mind you, of the entire flurry of accusations to hit Trump all at once, during an election and at the same time, makes it very suspicious, there wasn't any evidence that he abused women besides hearsay and his locker room talk recording. Gloria Allred, the same Clinton-supporting attorney who defended Summers Yarvos when Trump was accused of sexually harassing women on his show, is also in charge of defending Beverly Nelson, who is Moore's accuser. Think about that.